The Saw series is not only one of my favorites of all time, but the series that got me into horror. I am now an avid horror fan and consider it to be my favorite genre. And with the recent release of Saw X, it's now time to rank all of the Saw movies from worst to best. Unfortunately, not all Saw movies are made equally. I know everyone has their strong takes on these films, so let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Now let's get started with number 10, the worst of the worst. Saw, the final chapter. Saw 3D, Saw 7. Yes, a lot of names for this boy. This film killed me. It played a game with my emotions, and my emotions did not survive. I almost lost my love for this series because of this single freaking film. What a dumpster fire! Okay, it's not all that bad, but honestly it almost is. Let's start with the good though. First of all, I kind of like the return of Dr. Gordon. While it's not executed in the way I would prefer, there are some really neat tie-ins with the previous films, and him being the surgeon behind some of the traps that really makes sense to have him involved. Even if I don't really buy for a second that this is the same guy from the first movie. It's nice to have it tie into the original though. I theoretically love this setup of the movie as well. It's kind of meta with the man being tested, being a guy who wrote a book pretending to be a trapped survivor. I like the return of familiar faces from previous films in that support group, and the reverse bear trap does finally go off. There's also a couple gnarly-ish traps, like the hook coming through the throat. Yeah, you guys know what it is. However, just about everything else with this movie is a nightmare. From the horribly colored blood and color palette of the film, to the uninspired traps, the cheesy and out-of-place comedy in the intro, and the horrible 3D effects jammed in for literally no reason. I mean, even the traps generally are pretty uninventive and uninteresting. The movie just looks like the cheapest one in the entire series, and I heard the blood was colored so strangely because of the 3D component in the movie, and it just makes it feel like a parody. And the 3D didn't add anything, so it literally only took away from the film. So, I know this was initially supposed to be two movies, but maybe it was just better that it was one. 2 out of 10, and that's generous. Number 9, Saw 4. I always truly enjoyed the psychological component behind who was tested and why. That's what makes this movie simply unbearable, because the cop is getting tested because he wants to save people too badly? He's slightly boisterous and unruly? Like, what the hell is this guy doing in a torture chamber? Why? Who thought this was a good idea? On top of that, this is just the most frantic and fast-paced of all of the films, and I do like some of the backstory we get with Jigsaw, the autopsy is done well, and the movie doesn't look quite as cheap or as horrible as Saw 7 does. There are actually some really nice traps in here too, like the wife and her abusive husband, where she has to remove the ties she has to that husband by pulling the arrows through her body, which are attached to non-lethal sections in her, and very lethal sections for him. So every time she pulls one out, she's freeing herself and killing him. That's a really, really nice trap. There's a couple nice moments like that in the film, even some interesting transitions, and it technically has all the standard fanfare you need in a decent Saw film, but when the premise of the game is so ridiculous, it's hard to find myself buying into literally any of it. The twist is a creative reveal by the end, but when you think back on it, it just isn't as impactful or as meaningful as the best of the series. 4 out of 10. Number 8, Saw 5. This is typically seen as one of the most boring Saw films, and I can definitely see why. I can't necessarily say I disagree, but it doesn't commit the egregious sins that the previous two do on the list. There are core things in the last two that just break the fundamentals of the entire premise of the series, such as testing people who don't deserve it, or killing the author's wife at the end for some stupid reason, even though she did nothing wrong in Saw 7. But Saw 5 follows most of the rules of Saw. It just doesn't blow too many minds along the way. The tie-in for all of the characters that are being tested in the end is actually pretty nice, and there was a solid lesson for them by the end as well, that they could have all survived if they simply worked together from the beginning. Simple, but relatively effective. And I loved the self-performed tracheotomy that gets Strom out of his pickle, or the water cube. It also has some relatively slick visuals, such as that shot that just moves in right at the beginning. Like I said, it's not really a mind-blowing movie in any way, but it does the job. 5 out of 10. Number 7, Spiral from the Book of Saw. I was really, really looking forward to this film, but for some reason I didn't get around to seeing it until the last few months. And when I finally did, I was really disappointed. Not because it's a bad movie, but simply it didn't live up to my expectations. Every time a new Saw movie comes out, I'm bubbling with the hype that we'll get an entry as good as some of the classics, only to be let down time and time again. or... In any case, this movie has some great elements. The traps are really solid, not gratuitous, they are very poetic and specially formulated for the person being tested. The visuals see a pretty big upgrade here with warmer colors and slower pacing. I, for the most part, enjoy the characters and their dynamics. The problem with this movie is the atrocious script. I simply cannot stand for the dialogue in most of the movie. The delivery and acting can be... And there is almost nothing inventive in the twists and turns the story takes. It's predictable, linear, and unfortunately quite dull. It's a hodgepodge of some of the best and worst aspects of Saw, putting it towards the middle. 5 out of 10. Number 6, Jigsaw. I actually find Jigsaw to be quite similar to Spiral in a lot of ways. It was a reboot that got a slicker look with some warmer colors away from the blues and greens of the first few films. It's got quite a different feel with some light comedy brought in to break up the consistent insanity, and it's got some pretty weak dialogue too. But why do I think it slightly etches out Spiral then? Well, I personally find that the games themselves are really fun and interesting to sit through this time around, though the traps are slightly worse than Spiral, there are more of them, and the new visual flair keeps it fresh. They spend a little bit less time in the police procedures than in Spiral, which means less chances to mess up serious dialogue, although they probably still spend way too long on it. The secret apprentice trope has seriously got to go though. Like, honestly, how many of these movies have had a secret Jigsaw follower twist? This, Spiral, Saw 4, Saw 7, so 4 of the 5 I've talked about so far all have this, and they're all at the bottom. That's not a surprise. 5 out of 10. Number 5, Saw 6. Okay, now we're getting to the goodies. I think that there is a quite significant increase in Saw goodness from here to the top of the list, starting with Saw 6. A surprisingly poignant entry into the series. This film doesn't just see a rise in quality, but also in the classic poetic nature of the traps. Each test has a strong psychological purpose for the individual going through, and each is even more unique than the last. While it does take its time to get going, it got me emotionally invested by the end, really intrigued and curious on where the story would go. I find the lead character to be very interesting, and I like seeing the little character details as he goes through his tests, like him not wanting to look at the people he must kill. Hoffman isn't a character I was ever really intrigued by, but this entry sees him at his best. Being a full-on badass, slaughtering the entire room of cops just before they got him, and somehow finagling his way out of a reverse bear trap in epic fashion. Even if I'm not his biggest fan, both of those scenes are just badass. And I love the whole twist in this film, and it's not just like, oh my god, he was working with Jigsaw the whole time. It carries an emotional and personal punch. The twist is that the family isn't his own that he's been waiting for this whole time, but the family of a man he killed. And it changes everything, as at first it appears the family must choose if they or their father will live or die. But it's truly a test of forgiveness, where the son fails, although understandably so. It feels like a fittingly tragic tale, and there isn't much at all to complain about here other than the initial pacing. And it also has a top 2 or 3 trap in the series for most, with the shotgun carousel. An awesome, somewhat funny, horribly grotesque, and amazingly engaging scene. 7 out of 10. Number 4, Saw 3. I will admit it has been a year or so since I got through Saw 3. This may just be the most emotional Saw movie, and I found the core game to be such an amazing premise. The antithesis to Saw 4, perhaps, a truly solid foundation with a truly twisting and complex story. Is everything executed flawlessly in Saw 3? Well, no. It might be the goriest of all the Saw movies, and that is saying something. It's somewhat long and convoluted, but damn does it not just have some of the best payoffs in the series. The traps are so inventive and inspired, and it really is an emotional roller coaster. The Jigsaw-Amanda relationship is something truly profound to put at the forefront of the movie, and it made each of the first 3 Saw films have such a distinct flair. This is the first on the list to feature Tobin Bell as Jigsaw still alive, and it does wonders for the intrigue of the movie. He really is the core of what makes the series interesting, and having him present on the screen to deliver doubly intended dialogue is really hard to take your eyes off of. At times, the movie perhaps goes a bit too far with the gore, at times it gets a bit convoluted, but at the core is an emotionally investing roller coaster with a solid script and crazy gore. I'd consider this a horror classic, with the caveat that if you're not into Saw, this might be the movie that is the hardest to get into due to the intensity of it all. I heard there was rumors of people puking in the theater, and well, I could imagine it. This was a lot, especially from back then. From the rack to the angel trap and the pig vat, it's a lot. 7 out of 10. Number 3, Saw 2. Saw 2 might be the sleeper hit for a lot of people. It certainly does what a sequel should, upping the ante, adding a bunch new crazy traps, including potentially the most iconic, the needle pit. It also features an insane amount of screen time for Jigsaw, with again this doubly intended dialogue that's really interesting to peel back, especially after you've watched the movie before. The twist is truly probably, it might be the best in the series, honestly. And the movie's very coherent, where some of the ones lower on the list have poor acting, poor dialogue, things that don't really make sense, a lot of this logically follows. The only thing really holding back Saw 2 for me is how unlikable all of the characters are in this house with the nerve gas spreading through. There's so many times where obviously they could help each other, work together, they don't. I know they repeat the same trope in Saw 5, but some of the characters in here just feel like cartoon villains in a way. With a couple of character tweaks, I could have seen this movie placing even higher, but for having one of the most profound twists, upping the ante in a wonderful way, having Jigsaw at the forefront of the games, they really did create something special here. And you can tell that you have the original creators involved. Number 2, Saw X. This is the biggest shock of the year again. I have been disappointed time and time again by new Saw movies every time they come out. Of course, my girlfriends who watch all of the Saw movies in preparation for this, and we went out to the theater together, and what did we think? Well, I avoided all of the trailers. I had no idea what the premise of this film was. I wanted to go in as blind as possible, and I will say, I was shocked at the first 30 minutes of this movie. It is essentially like a slow medical drama mystery with some like comedy sprinkled throughout and some pretty beautiful cinematography, which is not something I expected to say about a Saw movie, some fun and interesting character work, and it really takes its time setting up the characters in the world and really gets you invested, especially if you don't understand what the twist that is coming will be with the medical service, because it really did not seem like it would be a scam, this miracle surgery to cure Jigsaw from his cancer, when you had the genuine scar from that very earnest-seeming individual that went to support groups with Jigsaw. So of course there was a strong suspicion that there was a scam going on here from us, but we weren't 100% sure where the movie was going, and that little twist of mystery is something that was prevalent in the first movie, and it really recaptured some of that uncovering the mystery energy that I felt was missing from a lot of the movies since. The slower pacing allows the movie to breathe, it allows the violence to really stand out, it's not constant in your face all the time, and it really gets you to care about Jigsaw and actually end up rooting for him, which is something that I just never expected to be doing. My biggest problem with the movie is probably just how unreasonable some of these traps are. So you have a guy that has to essentially do brain surgery on himself, which I don't think anybody could reasonably do that. They're unclear on what the goals are, like, oh, you have to get a certain amount of bone marrow out of your leg. Oh, you have to get a certain amount of brain out of your brain. And in my opinion, they got plenty and they did it in a reasonable time frame as well, but they still failed, which kind of pissed me off because it felt like people were achieving their goals but then being killed anyways. Didn't feel true to Jigsaw fashion to me. And you have the one where there was that radiation that would burn her face away, but wouldn't she just end up like dying of cancer like 50 years early because of the insane amount of radiation that she had blasted into her face and brain? But if we can ignore some of these logical inconsistencies, it is just a wild ride. To go from such a slow character drama at the beginning to then an insane amount of traps in the middle section, and then at the end having this essentially like battle of villains, it was a really gratifying roller coaster. Now, again, one of my other minor complaints, sorry, I'm bringing up complaints. I love this movie, that's why it's second. But these are the two things that just bring it down from potentially even being the best in the series for me. Just the way the ending is just very unsatisfying. I know that there's an intention to build off of that ending, but this wasn't established as a Saw X Part 1, right? This was established as its own standalone movie, and having an end with the villain, in I believe her name is Cecilia, that is so much worse than Jigsaw, having such a light fate and then just kind of dangling there at the end and you're not really sure what's going on and how that's going to play out, it kind of just leaves you with I kind of expected more from like this big grand Saw ending. There is epic moment after epic moment in this movie. It's filmed beautifully, probably the best in the entire series. Explores the Amanda character in a way that I'm really excited going forward. There's so much to love here. Honestly, I could see these rankings changing over time a little bit with a rewatch, but on initial viewing, those complaints that I had did bring it down just a little bit and enough to knock it just out of the first spot, leaving this with an 8 out of 10, and that leaves us with number one is the original Saw. Yep, that's it. This is the movie that started it all. My horror movie addiction and one of the top grossing series of all time. It's hard to believe how removed from the rest of the series this movie really is. And if you hate this series, you might actually still love this movie, which is hard to believe considering it spawned a lot of movies. There is very minimal gore here, and I think that's played really well, showing just enough of Gordon sawing off his foot that you don't have to see the whole thing. It's worse thinking about it than seeing it sometimes, right? As I said in the previous entry, the mystery of this movie is really what drives my intrigue with it all. Like, you're not sure what's going on. In the future movies, every single time, you already are aware of Jigsaw. You're already aware of his antics, his games, how he functions. But in this movie, discovering and unpeeling the mystery of what's going on and learning more about this character that's so amorphous and ambiguous and hard to fully grasp, as we only get glimpses of him and his character throughout the film, that's what makes this movie so special to me. It does feel dated at times. You can notice the budget at times. The effects are not always on point, but the mystery, the dialogue, everything is there for the most fundamental horror experience. Some of the execution can falter if you have such a core premise that is beautifully done. And you have some of the most iconic visuals in the whole series, such as the introduction of the reverse bear trap. For some reason, just seeing that device on her head just like can give me chills. It's so eerie the way it looks. And I know that James Wan did a good job designing this look himself. He was very passionate and had a vision there. I remember hearing he had to actually carry the reverse bear trap on a plane at one point, got stared at sideways. But yeah, just a horror classic for me that spawned my love for the genre. And for that, it has a special place in my heart, 9 out of 10. If you guys enjoyed this video, let me know down below and let me know your ranking down below. And if you want me to, I could do some more videos on Saw movies like traps, etc., etc. So again, let me know your thoughts, your rankings, and have a great day. Peace.